Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. Not that long ago, my PC at home died on me. It was an old laptop, it was around 7 years old, but I've been using it for making my tutorials for the last 5 years or so, and it's done a pretty good job at that, but I needed to have a replacement at my home setup. So I actually wanted to do something different. So before I was using PCs all the time, but I decided to try out the M1 Mac Mini because it's small and it's also pretty cheap. So in this video, I'm actually going to try out some different things. Mostly, I'm going to try out some things in Fusion and see how it's going to work out with the Mac Mini versus my studio setup, which is a PC. If you want to see the specs, they are right here. So mainly we're going to test out how some Fusion compositions and stuff works compared to the PC. So it's a Mac M1 Mini versus my studio PC video. So let's jump right into that. Oh, and by the way, if you want to learn filmmaking tips and tricks and DaVinci Resolve, I would recommend you to subscribe. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get right into this video. Okay, so for the first test here, we are just testing out some Fusion titles, which are built into DaVinci Resolve. So let's just find a couple to test out here on the Mac and see how that actually runs. So let's take this lower third here and let's have a look. And these are Fusion titles and they run pretty darn great. Of course, I do have Smart Catch enabled, but that's normal here. We have the same on PC, and that's running as well, or on the same way at least. Let's take another one here on the Mac. Let's take the Zipper title here. We'll try that. So I'm going to put that down onto the timeline and let's have a look. Yeah, it runs it pretty darn smooth, I must say. Here we are back on the PC and it's running it the same way as the other titles. So let's take a different title. Let's take this. This is a title with some 3D in. Runs that pretty smooth. And as soon as it's rendered, it's no problem at all for the Mac. And it's no problem at all for the PC either. It's running that just fine. No problem at all. Okay, so let's do a different test than this. Let's go and do a 3D text. So here I have a little 3D text, nothing fancy. And of course, here we are on the Mac. And it's running that pretty smooth. It's a 3D text just with a light effects. I'm going to the side here. And of course it's again with Smart Catch, but it runs it pretty nicely. So here we do the same thing on the PC. Again, you just have to catch up the render, but other than that, that runs pretty nice. Yeah, no problem to run this at all. Okay, so let's jump into Fusion here on the Mac, and I'm going to use some of the built-in templates. In this case, I'll let you use Lava, and I'm going to drag that down to the grid here in Fusion, and I'm just going to connect that to my media out. And let's have a look if it'll run this. Well, it does run this effect pretty fast and without too many problems, I think, here on the Mac. Again, it has to do a little bit of render, but when the render is done, there is no problem running this effect at all. Here we do the exact same effect on the PC. I'm going to connect it and it runs it pretty okay, I think. Again, it's like on the Mac, it needs to do a render of the effect first, but after that it will run it pretty darn smoothly. So there we have the render done, and yeah, no problem to run that smoothly at all. So here on the Mac, I'm going to take a smoke effect and I'm going to add that into the media out, and we're just going to see if it'll run that. Again, the same as the lava effect, after done one render, it will go just fine. So here in the edit page on the Mac, it will do the final render, but it looks pretty darn nice, I think, and runs it very smoothly. And there is actually a couple of notes to do this effect. So here on the PC, we're doing the exact same thing, and here you can see all of the different notes to make this effect. Again, like on the Mac, it needs to render the clip first or the effect first, of course, but after doing that, no problem at all to run it, as you see right here. Very nice. So for the next effect, I'm going to do fireworks. So I'm going to connect that to the media out here on the Mac. So no problem to do that at all. Very nice. So if we take a look here at the different notes, you can see there is quite a number of notes to make this effect. And nice, I think. So on the PC side, we're going to do the fireworks yet again. I'm going to connect it to the media out, and we're just going to run through it. Here I see a little bit of stuttering, but after doing the basic render, no problem to run this effect at all. So there we have it, running very nice on the PC as well. So for the next one, I'm going to take this radar effect, which is actually a huge amount of notes. And here on the Mac, we'll just see if it can run it at all. As you see, there is so many notes to do this effect here. So let's see if it will run it on the Mac. So actually, it's not that bad at all. It runs it pretty well, and of course, after doing the render, it will run it very smoothly. Here in the edit page, you'll see it'll need to do the render again. But as soon as that is done, it's running very smoothly. So here we go to the PC, same effect. And again, it'll need to do the render cache, but it'll run the effect pretty easy and pretty nice, I think. However, the render of this effect is a little bit longer on the PC than on the Mac M1 Mini. However, when rendered, no problem to run the effect at all. So this test was just to test out some different Fusion effects on the Mac Mini M1 versus my Studio PC. And I think the Mac Mini is doing a great job. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.